Insperity presents the Small Business Advocate Show with Jim Blasingame, brought to you by FedEx, CareerBuilder.com, and Palo Alto Software. This is a copyrighted production of Small Business Network, Inc., all rights reserved.
Won't you come away with me? Oh, where we are.
Welcome back, 17 Till. I'm Jim Blasingame. Thank you for staying with me. Having a great visit with our good friend Robert L. Dylan Schneider. Bob is a good friend of ours, and he's the author of Power and Influence: The Rules Have Changed. Also, the Bible on Public Relations, the Handbook of Public Relations, and the number of others that he's written that I've been a beneficiary of and have read and enjoyed. He's the chairman and the CEO and the founder and the head over at the Dylan Schneider Group, which is an outstanding PR firm, a global PR firm. Bob, you've been working on something you call a return to civility. Not only have you been working on this, you've been collecting great minds to talk about these things. You've got a series that you've had underway recently. You've already had two of these. You've got two more coming. Tell the audience a little bit about what it is, what you mean by this, and why we should care.
Manners, civility, decency, respect, these are all qualities that are extremely important. They really mark Americans, and they've gone away from us over the last 20 years, and I want to get it back. So I'm encouraging people to come forward. We had Charlie Osgood from CBS the other day. We're going to have Philip Howard talk about the noted author, who's going to talk about personal accountability. We're going to have Henry Kaufman talk about civility on Wall Street. Orrin Hatch, senator from Utah, is going to talk about civility in politics. We're going to have Gordon Gee from Ohio State talk about civility in the educational marketplace. And we're hoping to get Clint Eastwood to talk about civility in entertainment.
You already had Orrin Hatch was the first one. In April,
right.
And now where are these taking place?
They're taking place at the Carnegie Council, Jim.
Yeah.
And Andrew Carnegie, tough as he was, was a Scotsman who came over here many centuries ago, and really helped build America, and that's part of this whole thing as well.
And is that in Pittsburgh?
It's in Pittsburgh, but it's also in New York. It's
okay.
On 68th Street, New York.
Okay. Now civility. Bob is an elusive and scarce commodity. If any student of history, which I know you are, knows that if you go back to the founding days when those geniuses, the founders, set us on our path that we're currently on, and gave us this wonderful document, the Constitution. You know, they were hardly civil to each other. I mean, there was a lot of serious stuff. I mean, all the way to the point of an actual duel where one of the founders was killed by one of the others. I mean, that's, you know, couldn't your program have been called for back in those days, too?
There's a way to be civil, and there's a way to be civil. And you're right about the founding fathers. But I remember a number of years ago, in Dallas, Texas, there was a man named Jerry Farrington, who was the CEO of a company called Texas Utilities. There was a woman on the corner. She was bent over. She needed help across the street. Jerry Farrington, a man who made seven figures, took his time, walked across the street, helped her across the street. I'll never forget that, and never asked for a thing.
Well, that was a good deed. That's good for him. And I think there's still plenty of people will do that, Bob. The thing that concerns me, Bob, is that in politics today, I'm right and you're wrong, and there's nothing in the middle.
It used to be in politics, and I think we'll get back to this. And I think the next election and the one after that in 2016 are going to be key. It used to be that people could argue and then get together in the evening or in the afternoon and say, look, how are we going to settle this thing? How are we going to move the country forward? What's our objective? How do we get there and make something constructive happen for Americans? That's what we need right now.
Well, what do you think is causing this lack of civility these days?
I think it's several things. I think it's poor training, number one. I think that, frankly, moms and dads have let us down. We've got to change that. I think it's greed. I think people want theirs and they want it now. And I think we've got to change that. I think it's the development of different subgroups in New York and the rest of the country, and there's a real fear that the subgroup is going to take over. Hispanics, for instance, are playing a major role now in the United States.
Mm-hmm.
There's a fear on the part of a lot of people that Hispanics are going to move in. We're going to unlock and unleash the creativity of 51% of the American public over the next several years. Women. Those women are going to cause fear among men in terms of their jobs. We've got to overcome that fear. We've got to put all this behind us. So that gets to the issue of job creation. Obama has got to find a way to create thousands, millions of jobs, because those went away over the last 15 years. And if we can create those jobs, we'll eliminate the fear and we'll create prosperity and possibility.
I want to talk about those jobs in the next segment, but before we go there, one of the things that happened this week was there was a Republican debate in South Carolina. And what I understand, Herman Cain got the highest marks. And do you know why the people polled said he got the highest marks?
Because he used
plain English, and when the interviewer asked him questions, he answered the questions in plain English. He didn't give them political double talk. He didn't consult with a poll, with his pollsters. He spoke to them plainly. Wouldn't plain speaking, if we all use plain speaking, wouldn't that contribute to civility?
Yeah, it certainly would. And, you know, he's not going to win. But one of the reasons Donald Trump had this bump in the polls over the past couple of weeks is exactly that reason. Donald Trump said, we're going to get America back.
Right.
That's what Herman Cain said.
Yeah.
They were both terrific.
And so we need more people who have done something with their lives running for office, folks, and not people whose only claim is that they're ideologues, which is we have a lot of ideologues in Washington. We need more people who've made a payroll, for example, like Herman Cain has. Tintill, Bob Dinnerstein has made a payroll too, folks. I'd vote for him. Tintill, stay with us.
Insperity presents the Small Business Advocate Show with Jim Blasingame, brought to you by FedEx, CareerBuilder.com, and Palo Alto Software. This is a copyrighted production of Small Business Network, Inc., intended for the private use of our audience. Except as otherwise provided by copyright law, all other copying, redistribution, or publication without prior written consent is prohibited. All rights reserved. Prohibited. All rights reserved. Prohibited.